Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In this video, we are discussing about calculations and operators. So basically, we are discussing about operators in this video. Later, we will know how the calculations are affected when we are using operators. Okay, so now operators and types of operators we are discussing. Operators are symbols that triggers an action when applied to JavaScript variables and other objects. The data items on which operators act upon are called operands. They are classified into unary operators, binary operators, and ternary operators. Unary operators, those operators that require only single operand to act upon, are known as unary operators. For example, increment by decrement operators. Binary operators, those operators that require two operands to act upon are called binary operators. Binary operators are classified into arithmetic operators, comparison operators, logical operators, assignment operators, and bitwise operators. Ternary operators, these operators require three operands to act upon, for example, conditional operator. Okay, so now actually in JavaScript we have only seven categories of operators. One is arithmetic operators, assignment operators, comparison operators, logical operators, bitwise operators, miscellaneous operators, and string operators. Now, coming to the arithmetic operators, we have addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, module, increment, and decrement. Again, this increment and decrement operators are of two kinds. One is forced increment and pre-increment, forced decrement and pre-decrement. These are the four kinds of operators. Again, the operators are classified. Okay, so the usage of addition is C is equal to A plus B. A plus B value after sum of A and B will be assigned to C. Similarly, after subtracting from A to B, and that value is assigned to C, and multiplying A and B and assigned to C, divide A by B, the quotient will be assigned to C. A module B, the remainder will be assigned to C. These are the different things happen in operators, arithmetic operators. Now assignment operators. Now the assignment operators is equal to represents assigning. Okay, so similarly 20 is assigned to A. Similarly, some calculations are also assigned to a variable. So plus equal to, minus equal to, multiplication equal to, division equal to, module equal to. These are the different kinds. When A plus is equal to B, it means that A is equal to A plus B. A minus is equal to B indicates A is equal to A minus B. A into is equal to B is assigned as A is equal to A into B. A module A divided by B is equal to A is equal to A by B. A module is equal to B is equal to A mod B. This is the meaning. Only when these two are equal, the variables, these two are equal, then only the assignment operators are plausible. Now comparison operators. Comparisons are nothing but a relation. The relation may be greater than equal to, less than equal to, not equal to, and triple equal to. These are the different things are available. So greater than equal to, less than equal to, not equal to, exactly equal to in value and type. So this equal to means normal comparison. This is equivalent to means it also checks the type. Both the variables are of same type or not also it checks. Okay, that is the exact meaning of that. Next one is logical operators. Logical operators, they are logical AND, logical OR, and logical NOT. AND means both the relations or comparisons are true, then it returns true. Otherwise, it returns false. Logical OR means any one of the relation or comparisons are true, then it is true, otherwise it is false. True means false and false means true. So it also indicates with the table A is one, P is one comparison and Q is another comparison, then P logical and Q indicates both are true, then it is true, otherwise it is false. Logical R is indicated any one is true, then it is true, otherwise it is false. Logical not means true means false and false, sorry, false means true and true means false is indicated. This is what exactly the meaning of that. So the next is bitwise operators. Bitwise and bitwise are tilde operator. Bitwise are bitwise not, shift right, shift left and shift right with zero filling. Okay, these are the different kinds of operators we have. Already we are discussed in detail with the programming example in C and programming in Java. Programming in C and programming in Java. Almost all are same, but small changes are happened in this scenario of videos. But while I am explaining practically, definitely I will cover all the examples. Okay, but here I am not taking any numbers and explanations are very less when compared to previous thing. So the next one is miscellaneous operators. Dot, semicolon, object property or method of separator M. Okay, question mark. So condition operator. Delete, delete specified object. New, create new object. This, reference current object. Type of object, number string and so on. Void, evaluate expression without returning a value. These are the miscellaneous operators, also called as special operators in JavaScript. Okay, finally the last one comes to true, that string operators. Plus indicates concatenation. It is also similar to Java. Java also plus indicates a concatenation, and here also plus indicates a concatenation. Let us take a small example here. String where F name is equal to Savi and var L name ID source, when a new variable full name is equal to F name plus L name, so that automatically it brings a Savi ID source. That is what exactly. In between the strings we need to use black slash, then we use double slash, single quote we need to use double quote, slash b means backspace, f means form feed, n means line feed, r means carriage return, t means horizontal tab, v means vertical tab. These are the different kinds of in the middle of the text we are using it. Obviously that respective symbols will be printed in the entire process. So I hope you understand the JavaScript operators. So we discussed in this video, we discussed what is an operator and types of operators, followed by the types of operators are arithmetic operators, assignment operators, comparison operators, logical operators, bitwise operators, miscellaneous operators and string operators. Okay, so in the next video we need to learn practically how we are implementing these things. Thank you.